morning to everyone. In the last lecture, we discussed on some magical patterns on squares, and we have studied two type of pattern. So first pattern is adding triangular numbers. We had add a numbers which can form a triangular pattern, and by adding its consecutive triangular pattern we get a square number. That means to find its perfect square number we can obtain, so we should do the triangular star pattern. Second thing we studied that is a numbers between perfect square numbers. That means we have studied that how we can obtain the how many natural numbers between two perfect square numbers. Then we got an equation, that is n plus 1 whole square. If we revise it, that is n plus 1 whole square minus n square, that equals to 2n plus 1. Clear? So this is the basic formula to obtain the number of natural numbers. How many natural numbers are exist between two consecutive perfect squares? Like how many numbers between 144 and 121? Because 144 is the square of 12 and 121 is square of 11. So we can obtain it directly. The smaller number is our n. So we are taking the twice of this. This is our n. So twice of 11 is 22. So there are 22 natural numbers between these two perfect squares. Clear? And to find the difference between two squares of consecutive number, to find the difference between these two, we should add 1 in this. So this is the difference between two square numbers. Yes, so we have studied this. Now, today we will discuss some more interesting patterns. So, let me understand about the third interesting pattern, and that is adding odd numbers. That means by adding a sequential odd numbers, we get a sequential square perfect square numbers. Clear? Let me understand how it comes. First of all, let I add 1. This is an odd number. So this one is the square of number 1. If I add 1 plus 3, what is this addition? What is this addition? Here this addition is 4. So this is the square of 2. Clear? This is the square of 1. This is the square of 2. Here, if I add 1 plus consecutive odd number is 3, then next consecutive odd number is 5. 3 plus 5, 8 plus 1, 9. So this addition is 9. That is the square of 3. Clear? If I add 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, then 7 plus 5, 12 plus 3, 15 plus 1 gives 16. So this is the square of 4. Again, let I add 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. So this addition gives the next complete square number is 25. If you add these, then this addition is 25. And 25 is the perfect square of 5. Clear? Again, if I add 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11, then what is the next perfect square number? That is 36. So we get 36 by adding the consecutive perfect square number, consecutive odd numbers, we get perfect square number always. Clear? So here is x square. So by using this type of pattern, we can check whether the given number is perfect square number or not. Like if I take an example of example that if I have a number 50, sorry, let me take a perfect square number first, like 84. So 64. Here, so 64 is a natural number. Let me check this number is perfect square or not. Here, so we should subtract term by term. That will give again the addition of the whole numbers. Here, that means if we subtract first 1, that means 64 minus 1 gives 63. Now 63 minus next digit is 1 and 3. Now 63 minus 3 is 60. Again 60 minus next digit is 5. 60 minus 5 is 55. Again 55 minus next digit is 7. So 55 minus 7 gives 48. Again 48 minus 9, what we gave, the answer is 39. Here again 39 minus next digit is 11. 39 minus 11, that is 28. Again 28 minus this is 11, next digit is 12. Sorry, 30. Odd number, you should take odd numbers. The next number is, next whole number is 30. 28 minus 30, that is 15. And lastly, 15 minus 15, we get 0. So, the final answer is 0. That indicates that, now, final answer is 0, so we can say that this 64 can be represented the sum of these consecutive odd numbers. If we add 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15, that addition is 64. Clear? So the addition of this all thing, we get 64. We are taking the subtraction here. What does it mean? That means this addition is, let me take this example, let I take this number 36. So if I subtract 11 on both sides, what happens? 36 minus 11, here 11 will be cancelled. Again, let it subtraction of 9 on both sides. So this 9 and here 9 is subtracted, here 9 is cancelled. Again, I can take subtraction of 7 on both sides here. So this 7. I try to explain you very well. Here is 36. So let me take the subtraction of 11 on both sides. What happened here? 11 is cancelled out. So what is remaining? 9. Now let me take subtraction of 9. This is also cancelled out. And here is 9. Let me take to remove this 7. Okay. Take the subtraction of 7. 7 will be also cancelled here because minus 7 plus 7 will be 0. Again here 5 will be cancelled by taking subtraction of 5 on both sides. 5 will be cancelled. Again I take the subtraction of 3 on both sides. This 3 will be cancelled. Again I take the subtraction of 1 on both sides. What happened here? The remaining answer is 0. That means if I subtract these whole odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11 from 36, you get 0. That means this 36 is the addition of all things. Clear? Okay, the addition is, addition gives 36. Similarly, we can subtract this sequence of whole number. If the answer is remainder is 0, then we can see that the given number is perfect square. Given number is perfect square number. Here this is a perfect square number. If I take the rest of these numbers like 65, then what is the remainder? Final remainder became 1. If I subtract here 16 minus, the final remaining is 16. 16 minus 15, we get remainder 1. And then we will subtract to remove this 1. Instead of 64, if I take 65, what happens? The final remainder is 1. And to make it 0, we have to subtract again. The next number is 17. 1 minus 17, we get minus 16. So this is not 0. We cannot get 0 here. Clear? So this number is not a perfect square number. This number is not a perfect square number. Clear? So we can verify the given number by subtracting sequential odd number. If the remainder is 0, then the given number is perfect square, otherwise not. Clear? So we can verify it by using this adding numbers pattern. Clear? By using this number pattern. We are doing this thing. Clear? Now let me move on new interesting pattern, and that is a sum of consecutive natural numbers. A sum of consecutive natural numbers. The sum of consecutive natural numbers. That means here is we are taking the sum of consecutive odd numbers. Here is the sum of consecutive natural numbers. So how we get this pattern? Here if I take a number, a perfect square number like 4. So what is the addition of perfect square? If I take 4, so there is no consecutive addition, so we get the number 4. Clear? But the next number is 9. If I take this 9, from 9 it is applicable to all perfect square numbers. Below 9 number, that is not applicable. But above 3 square, this system is applicable for all perfect square numbers. So here, I am taking a number, natural number 9. That is the addition of two things. 4 plus 5 is a consecutive natural number. Clear? So addition of these two numbers. Now, how can we represent this number? How can we represent this number? Like here is 9, so I can take this number as 3 square. I can take this number as 3 square. So, I can take this number as 3 square minus 1 by 2, and this number can be represented as 3 square plus 1 by 2. See, what is 3 square? 9 minus 1, 8 by 2, that is 4. And 3 square is 9 plus 1, that is 10 by 2, use 5. So, we can obtain to represent any square number into its consecutive natural number, addition of consecutive natural numbers, then we should do this pattern. Clear? Let I take another example that if I want to represent a 9 square into its consecutive two numbers, addition of two numbers, then by adding these two numbers we get this 9 square. So we know that 9 square is 81. So here we represent the addition of two consecutive natural numbers. First number can you represent as 9 square minus 1 by 2. 9 square is 81 minus 1 by 2, that is 80 by 2, that is 40. Similarly, we can obtain the next number because next number is the consecutive natural number. So next number is always 41. Or we can find it in this method also. 9 square plus 1 by 2. 9 square is 81 plus 1, that is 82. 82 by 2, that is 41. Here, so in this manner we can obtain that these two consecutive numbers are available to obtain this result. Clear? So, to obtain this sequence, we should do this pattern. That means, in general, if I want to find the n square, then this pattern gives n square minus 1 by 2, and to find next number is n square plus 1 by 2. Clear? So, here in the example, there are some given questions like try this. Then, sorry, open the page number 94. And some questions are given for these type of pattern, right? This. And that is, first question is 121, 55, 81, 49, and 69. So you may try this, but we are taking, in this example, we are taking the example of 64. You will take the example of 121. Then you can subtract. The pattern is similar. We are doing the same pattern. This pattern is applicable for all questions, all 5 questions. For number 121, take the 121, subtract first 1, 120, then 120 minus 3, then again subtract 5 from the answer, we get new answer, subtract 7 from the new answer, we get second new answer. Clear? And do this. If remainder is 0, final answer is 0, then the given number, that means 121, is perfect or not, you can find it. Clear? So you may do this 5 examples by using this type of pattern. Clear? And at last you should write this, given number is perfect square or not. Clear? Now for the fourth one, some try this given. First is 21 square. How can it represent 21 square? Let me try this. First is 21 square. So, how can we represent the 21? And then this one given example. And here this is 21. So, how can I represent 21 square in 2 8s? Addition of two consecutive natural numbers. N is 21, so 21 square minus 1 by 2. So how can I do the 21 square first of all? We should take this 21 square minus 1 by 2. So 21 square, we should remember this square is up to 25. So all numbers are given up to 90 or 20, maximum number is 21. Clear? So you should remember the squares up to 25. Here, square of 21 is 441. Here is 441 minus 1. 441 minus 1 divided by 2. That is 440 divided by 2. That is 220. Clear? So we get, to find the first number plus second number, first number can be obtained in this way, that is 220. So next number can be represented very easily, that 221. Clear? You can obtain it by this way also. 21 square plus 1 divided by 2. 21 square is 441 plus 1, that is 442. By 2, that is 220. Clear? So you can write this, that means you can represent 21 square as the summation of these two. Yeah. Second one, do you think the reverse is also true? It means A is the sum of any two consecutive positive integers is perfect square of a number. Give example to support your answer. So let you take any two consecutive natural numbers. Like if I take this number is started from 9. 9 is a natural number and this is started from 3 square. If I take greater number, greater than any value 9, let it be the addition of 14 plus 15. What is this addition? 29. Is 29 perfect square or not? Is 29 perfect square or not? Let it be. For question number 2, I am taking two natural numbers. Natural number 1 is 14, so its consecutive natural number is 15. So this addition is 29. This addition is 29. And this 29 is not perfect square. This is not perfect square number. So we can say that this, the reverse of this is not possible for always time. Clear? So this is not true always. Reverse process is not true. So the answer of second is no, there is no possibility for every time for all consecutive to natural numbers. Clear? Now next pattern is product of two consecutive even or odd natural numbers. So let I use the third pattern. Pattern number 5, product of two consecutive even or odd natural numbers. That means here the consecutive even or odd. So you can take any two. Let us take the two consecutive odd numbers. In the example there is given 11 to 13. What is the use of this? What is the use of this? How we can find this? Let us take an example of 29 into 31. What is the use of this? First of all, I am explaining you. What is the product of this? 29 into 31. What is the product of this? So you will do in this manner that 29 multiplied by 31. It is multiplied. There is no change in the answer. So here 31 2 is 62, 9 1 is 9, 9 is 27, then addition is 9, addition is 9, and here addition is 8. So answer is 899. Here, so we do this multiplication in this manner, and this manner is somehow long. Now, what is the shortcut here to obtain this answer? So, how can I write this? Here I can write this as 30 minus 1 and I can write this as 30 plus 1. Is it clear or not? So 30 minus 1 and 30 plus 1, and when you obtain this multiplication gives here 30 minus 1 and 30 plus 1 can be represented in this manner, that 30 square minus 1 square. Square minus 1 square, but 1 square is always 1. Clear? So, if any number, any consecutive odd or any consecutive even value, then we can represent that number. Like if I take two number like 47, I am taking the even number 48 square, 48 into 50. So what is this product? This product to find in this manner is very long. So you can, if you find this, then 49 minus 1 into 49 plus 1. That means I can write this by multiplying these two. When I open this bracket, I can write this manner that 49 square minus 1. Clear? So when I do this square, 30 square is what? 3 is a 9 and 0 will twice. 900 minus 1 is 899. So the product of these, we can say that 899. Product of these two is 899. So I can represent this in manner and I can solve this way. Similarly, by taking this square of 49, we can obtain this multiplication. This value is very greater. Some examples are given. In the question that 44 multiplied by 46, so you can take the square of 45. Here, if I take, this is the first example, this is the second example, let me take the third example that 44 multiplied by 46. How can I multiply these two? Then I can write here 45 minus 1 into 45 plus 1. Here, this multiplication gives 45 square minus 1 square. Now 45 square is, and I am explaining you that if unit place is 5, then how can you obtain the square of this? 4 5s are, what is the next number of this 4? Multiply this 4 with the next natural number, not this 5. Instead of 4, if that is 8, then we should multiply 8 with 9. Here instead of 4, sometimes it may be 7. Then 7 multiply by 8. That means you should multiply this 10th place with its next natural number. So 4 multiply by 5, 4 5s are 20. So write this 20. So this is your square of this. And minus 1, so it is 2024 is your answer. So product of 44 into 46 is 2024. Clear? So this is quite easy instead of this manner. So you can find the product of two consecutive even numbers. Clear? You can find this sequential multiplication. Clear? And the last magical pattern. And this is so really magical pattern that when you will free and you are doing some, you are playing with the calculator, then you do like this type of patterns. Clear? So let me do this pattern. Pattern number 6, last pattern is, suppose 1 square, so what is the square of 1? That is only 1. 1 square is 1. Now what is the square of 11? What is the square of 11? Here, I explained you, but not in detail. I have explained this, how can we obtain the 11 square? So, we should do this as 1 and 1, both will come at the end. That means the series may occur here. So let us start the series here, that here is 1, we get 2 and again 1. That means here is 2, 1, then we should write the series up to 2, 1, 2, 1. Clear? Let I do the 1, 1, 1, that means 111 square. So how can I write this 111 square? So how many 1s are there? There are 3 1s. Then I should write this series as 1, 2, 3. Then first is ascending order and then is descending order. So here is, I should write this as 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. Series 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. Clear? 11 square is 121. 1 square is 1. Clear? So what is the square of 4? How many ones are there? There are 4 ones. Then I can write the series up to 4. Firstly in ascending order, and then I will write it in descending order. So 4 ones are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let I write in descending order. 4, 3, 2, 1. 4 remains common. We should not take it as repeated. Clear? Now again, if there are 5 ones, what is the square of 11,111? This number is very greater. So how can you obtain this square? So you have to write this again. The series up to 5, because there are 5 ones. So I can write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again descending order, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is square of this 11 square. So now we got this interesting pattern. Clear? Now there are some questions are given in the try this. Write a square making use of the above pattern. Number 1 contains how much 11s? Sorry, how much ones? There are 6 ones in the first question. Question number 1 implies this. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ones. And I want to write the square of these ones. This is useful for only squares, not the cube or not the others. Clear? This is only 2, 4 square of ones. Here. So here are square of 6 ones, and I have to write square of these. So what is the answer directly? So here is 6. So let I write this pattern as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then descending order 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Clear? So this is your answer. Now the next is 3, 6 and 7. The next second answer, second question contains 7 ones. Then how I can write this? So the series is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, up to 7. Then take this in descending order, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Clear? You may do this in the calculator also, you will get answer in this sequence also. But if your calculator can display up to only 8 digit or 9 digit, so you can take this square up to 111, not this, because this contains 5 and 4, 9 digits. Sometimes calculator may give you 8 digit, so you can do this square up to this, not this one. Clear? So to do these squares for greater ones, then we can do in this manner. And the last one, another interesting pattern. So what is another interesting pattern? Let me take this. Here is 7 square. First of all, 7 square. So we know this 7 square is 49. 4 and 9. Now, what is the square of 67? That means this the digit is 1 less than 7. This digit is less by 1. So here, you should remember one thing. How many digits in the natural number? Here is 1. So how many digits in the square? We get 2. Clear? How many digits in this natural number? There are 2. 67, there are 2 digits. So we get 4 digits in the answer. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 digits are there. If I take the 6, 7 whole square, here is 3 digits. So I get 6 digits in the answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 digits in the answer. If I take 6, 6, 6, 6, 7 square, Then how many digits are there? 1 6 is greater. So how many digits are there? Here is 4 digits. So I get the answer in 8 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Clear or not? Now, put the 9 instead of 7. Here, how many 7 is? 1. So I put 1 9. Here, how many 7? How many 7? All contains 1 7. So, let me put the place of 7, let me put 9. So, at the last place is 9, first of all. Then, this digit is less 1. The previous digit is less 1. So, 7 minus 1 is 6. Here, 9 minus 1 is 8. Here, so we get, see this answer. Now, put the half of the remaining. It means, put the remaining blanks by 4. Here, remaining blanks are 2, and put this by 4. You can take this and this also. Given pattern is of 1 digit, so answer pattern is of 2 digit. Here is 1 7, so put the unit place is 9, and the rest length is 4. There is 26. Clear? Now, again do this single pattern. Here is 1 7, so put here 1 9. Again, how many 6 are here? Here is 2 6's. Then I have to write here 2 8's. That means here is 7, so 1 is less 6. Here is also 1 less. So here is 9. So I have to write here 8, which is 1 less. Here is also 8, 1 less. Here. Now the rest of blanks will be filled by 4. Put here these blanks by 4. This is your answer. Again here, unit place is 7, unit place should be 9 instead of 7. Here is 3 6's, so I have to put 3 8. 9 minus 1, 8, 8, and 8. Here, the rest of blanks will fit by 4. This is the answer of the squares. So, what is the square of the given question? Like, in the try this, first question is, there are 6 6's and then 7. 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 whole square. What is the square of this? So total how many digits are there? 7 digits are there. So the answer contains 7 to the 14. So the answer contains 14 blanks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Clear? And then at unit place is 7, so I have to write here 9. How many 6's? There are 6 6's, so I have to put 6 8. 1 less, here 1 less is 6, here 1 less is 8. So let I put 6 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Clear? And remaining all blanks you should fill by 4. This is your answer. Clear? So by combining these all digits, we get the answer. So you can find the answer of the next one also. Clear? So today we have studied some interesting patterns. How we can obtain the perfect squares, or sometimes we obtain some multiplication of consecutive natural numbers, or consecutive odd numbers, or consecutive even numbers in short method. Clear? So this pattern are very useful. Sometimes how can you obtain the squares of the bigger ones and bigger this type of digits, this type of numbers, we can obtain this in this shortcut pattern. Clear? So we will solve exercise number 6.1 in next lecture. Thank you.